While trade and transportation play a key role in the success of the Port of Tacoma today, trade and transportation also played a key role in the settlement of Tacoma and the Puget Sound region years ago. As early as the 1850s, ships were attracted to Tacoma and to its naturally deep, sheltered harbor. Then, in 1873, the Northern Pacific Railroad chose Tacoma as the western terminus of its transcontinental line. This decision brought more people, more cargoes, and more business and trade opportunities to our city and to its waterfront. Lumber mills and warehouses filled with grain and other regional products line Tacoma's waterfront, along what is now Schuster Parkway and the Ruston Way area. At that time, most of this land was owned by the railroads. Then in 1911, the Washington State Legislature passed a law that enabled public port districts to be established. In 1918, the Port of Tacoma was voted into existence by Pierce County citizens. The port started out on 240 acres of land in the Tideflats, and the first ship called at the port in 1921. Major cargoes that were shipped out of the port in its early years included logs, lumber, grain, and agricultural products. During World War II, more than 30,000 people worked at the Todd Pacific shipyards in the Tacoma Tideflats, building ships to support our nation's war effort. After the war, the port embarked on a major plan to extend both the Blair Waterway and the Hylivus Waterway. This added additional areas where new docks could be built, and the dredge material filled in land that could then be used for warehouses and other trade-related activities. In 1985, the Port of Tacoma emerged as a world-class container port when two of the world's top shipping lines, Sealand and Maersk, started calling in Tacoma. K-Line came to the port in 1988, and Evergreen came in 1991. Hyundai started calling at the port in 1999, and Yang Ming in 2005. Today, the port is one of the leading container ports on the West Coast, with four of the top 10 container shipping lines in the world calling Tacoma. While the port started out on 240 acres of land, it now encompasses about 2,400 acres of land. Of that, about 700 are still available for development. Tacoma's advantages today include many of those that first attracted ships to Commencement Bay in the 1800s. Deep water, excellent transportation connections, a wide range of agricultural and forest products available for export, and modern container handling facilities. These advantages will not only help guide the port's future growth and development, but also the overall strength and diversity of our regional economy.